Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to create a quick survey and how to download the responses from that survey into Microsoft Excel so that you can analyze those results. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So I'm going to start off by going to office.com and going down here to apps. If you don't have this button here, you can also go up to this little waffle grid right here called the app launcher and click on forms. So because we're doing a survey today, let's go to a new form right here. And let's say we're going to do a survey today on board games. And we could put a little picture in here. So let's go to Insert Media and let's just look up board games. And let's just pick this picture down here and say add. So there's a lot of different types of survey questions that you can do that are all downloadable to Excel. So let's look at a few of those right now. If I click this Add New button, let's go over each one of these. First, let's do a choice. And let's say, how often do you play games? Sometimes when I type in a question, Microsoft Forms is smart enough to sense what type of options I might want to have. So you can see it says daily, weekly, monthly, seasonal, yearly, never. So I have the option to add all of those, but I really am only interested in daily, weekly, or monthly. And I can also come down here and add the other option, which allows the respondent to type in something in the blank. So I'm going to add that one. And I can make this a required question or not. So I am going to require this answer right here. And I can also allow for multiple answers, but in this case, I wouldn't have multiple answers. So that is the option type question. Next, let's go down here to add new, and we'll add a text one. And we'll just say, what is your favorite game? And we are also going to require that answer. This long answer option here is for a response that might be a little bit longer than a few words. But in this case, your favorite game is not going to be a long answer. So let's just leave that. Next, I'll add another new question. And I'm going to add a rating. And a rating type question allows you to have stars. Or it also allows you to have numbers, like a number 1 through 5. So let's see what that looks like if I select number. You can see right up here. But I like the stars, so I'm going to go back to that one. And I can have anywhere from 2 to 10 stars. I'm going to leave 5 for now. And my question here, how much do you like the website Board Game Geek? And then I'm going to come down here and add another type of question, which is a date. And I'm going to just ask, when is the last time you played a game? And I'm not going to require this question. And I'm also not going to require this question up here. And next, I'm going to go to Add New. And I'm going to select this down arrow. And I'm going to insert a Likert, which is like a matrix. And I'm just going to say, rate the following games. And as soon as I type in poor down here as one of the headings for the columns, I'm also going to get these options up here. So I'm going to add fair, good, very good, and excellent. So for my row headers, I'm going to put a few games. Settlers of Catan, Ticket to Ride, and I can add more rows just by clicking add statement right here. So I'm going to do that. And I'm going to add Power Grid, and let's say Manhattan Project. And I could keep going, but this is enough for now. So the Likert here allows the responder to score what they think about a whole list of options over here with the categories poor, fair, good, very good, and excellent. So for my next question, I'm going to go to Add New, and I'm going to hit this down arrow, and I'm going to put in a net promoter score. And I'm going to say, how likely are you to recommend our company to a friend? And by default, it says not as likely over here and extremely likely over here. And that's good. I will keep those default answers. But if I wanted to reorder any of my questions on the screen, I could just use this up arrow and this question would move up. Now it's number 5 instead of number 6, but I'm going to move it back down so it is number 6. So usually the Net Promoter Score is the last question on a survey that you may be having. So let's leave it like that for now. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. And next, if I want to, I can go up to preview and I can get an idea of what my survey is going to look like. So here's my questions, number 1 through 6, one of each type of question. And there's a submit button at the bottom. But I'm not ready to release this yet. If I hit the back button, I can come in here and I can add a theme. So let's add some color to our survey before we send it out. So let's just say I pick this little space theme down here and I go up to preview. And this is what my final survey will look like. So I'm going to hit the back button and go up to send. And I have a link right here. And I can copy this link into an email and send it out to anyone that I want to take my survey. I can also go up to these three dots right here and go to settings. And I can toggle on and off whether or not I'm accepting responses for my survey. Otherwise, that link will be up forever and you will always have survey responses pouring in. I can also set a start date for my survey so I can schedule it for in the future. I can also select an end date so I don't have to worry about turning off the accept responses. It'll be done automatically by a certain date. I can also get an email notification for each of my responses, or I can customize thank you messages and say thanks for taking our survey. But I'm going to take off the start and end date just for purposes of our demo right here. And now we're all ready to go. So I'm going to go back to send, copy my link, send this out in an email, and wait for the responses to come in. So let's pretend that I'm a responder getting the survey. So here's the link to my survey, and I'm going to go fill this out and say, I play games monthly. What is my favorite game? So let's just say I like Cryptid, because right now I really like to play those logical deduction games. Down here, how much do I like the website Board Game Geek? Let's say I have heard of it and I really do like it, so I'm going to give it a 5-star review. When's the last time I played a game? If I click here, I actually get a date picker. So I'm going to say I last played a game on Monday night, and then rate the following games. Kinda sick of Settlers, kinda sick of Ticket to Ride, but I really love Power Grid and Manhattan Project. So I will give those an excellent. And then how likely am I to recommend this company to a friend? Extremely likely. And now I'm going to hit the submit button. And then you can see my custom message right here. Thanks for taking our survey. And if I go back to the Microsoft form that I was working on earlier, I can now look up here and in this circle, I can see that I have one response. So if I click on the responses, I can see some metrics on my responses. But here's where it gets really cool. If I hit the open in Excel button, I can see up here that I've downloaded an Excel spreadsheet. And let's open that up and see what kind of data is in there. So I can see when the survey started, when it was completed, so I can track how long it takes for someone to take my survey. And then I can over here see all of the responses to all of my questions. So let's pretend I'm a different user and I'm going to enter a different survey. How often do you play games? I play daily. What is my favorite game? Let's say 1830. How much do I like Board Game Geek? Not much at all. And when's the last time I played a game? Well, I played yesterday. And then rate the following games. Let's say I love all of these. And how likely am I to recommend our company to a friend? Let's say I'm not very likely to do that. And if I hit submit. Now, if I go back to Microsoft Forms, you can see that there are two responses here. And if I open in Excel, I have now downloaded another spreadsheet. And if I hit that one, you can now see that this one has both responses inside the spreadsheet. So hopefully you can see what a useful tool this will be for collecting data and how easy it is to send out a survey to whatever group of people you need to send them out to. One thing I do want to mention here is that if you are using a Microsoft Office Business subscription, then this process gets really cool because instead of saying open in Excel, you can have created the form directly from Excel so that any responses that you receive automatically go into the spreadsheet where you created the form from. I don't have Microsoft Business right now, so I can't demo that for you, but I did want to mention that that is a little perk of having that over the home version or using just the free office.com version. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction on how to create a simple survey and then download the responses to Microsoft Excel. I hope you get lots of feedback for whatever survey you would like to send out. As always, thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.